Hey, wrestling fans, welcome to another episode, a new episode, finally, of 360 Wrestling Fanatic, episode 284. As always, I am your host, Lance Brack. Thank you for tuning in. It's good to be back, finally. I got lazy again, took another long break from the podcast, but back now, and we'll see if this return lasts this time. Hopefully it will, but we'll have to wait and see about that. And not only is this the audio podcast on Spreaker, Apple Podcasts, Anchor, Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and some other ones that I cannot think of right now, but also doing the live stream on YouTube. And I remember one thing that I missed that the last time I did a live stream was the first one in quite a while that I have done, so I forgot, yeah, to name the stream. I forgot all about that, so it just said on YouTube, just a live with Restream or something like that. I forgot to name it, so that's what it said. And like I said, this is also the audio podcast as well. And since I am behind, very behind, gotta talk about a show I didn't have a chance to talk about on here. I was planning on it, but then after the WrestleMania recap, never did another podcast since then. So right now, going to talk about Ring of Honor, finally, Supercard of Honor, their first show back since AEW owner Tony Khan purchased the company. So I'm going to just go through it real quick. I was going to do a full recap, but then, like I said, I never got around to doing that episode of the podcast. So right now, I'm gonna talk about Ring of Honor, Supercard of Honor real quick. But first, I just want to say there were a lot of great shows over WrestleMania weekend. GCW had quite a few good ones, and Impact Wrestling Matches of the Multiverse, I think it was called, good show. I recommend checking that out. High Spots, their super show, good Triple A show, and all very good shows. I recommend all those ones, because if you it was probably hard over WrestleMania weekend to watch every show that was going on. I'm sure maybe by now you could have watched some live, some on the replay on Fight TV, the Fight TV app. But right now I'm going to talk about Ring of Honor, Supercard of Honor, finally. Like I said, there was an anticipation leading into this one, their first show back. And the question was, what's it going to be like now being owned by Tony Khan? We have not seen anything from Ring of Honor since. No shows, no nothing. I haven't really heard much either. We've seen Ring of Honor wrestlers show up in other promotions. Jonathan Gresham has been defending the Ring of Honor World Championship all over the world. Honor No More, now in Impact Wrestling. And other promotions, the former Ring of Honor Women's Champion, Roxy, now signed with WWE. And a lot has happened, quite a bit in the world of pro wrestling since then. Since I've done the podcast, I should say. But, like I was going to, Ring of Honor, Supercard of Honor, right now, 2022, we start off Alex Zane and Swerve Scott. And Swerve picks up the win, or Swerve Strickland now, I should say, since he's no longer in WWE. Now he's going by Swerve Strickland, I believe, in AEW. And Brian Cage defeats Ninja Mac. Jay Lethal taking on Lee Moriarty. Lethal gets the win, but he wins this match with a low blow to Moriarty, cheating, taking advantage, breaking the rules a little bit to get the win. But win is a win. We have women's action up next. Mercedes Martinez defeating Willow Nightingale via submission. And the Ring of Honor World Tag Team Championships are on the line. FTR versus the Briscoes. Great match here. And FTR win this one. And then the Young Bucks come to the ring and attack the Briscoes. FTR save them. The World Television Championship now on the line. Minoru Suzuki defeats Red Titus to become the champion. Sorry about that. The Ring of Honor Pure Championship on the line. Josh Woods taking on Wheeler Yuta, who's of course been in AEW for a while now. Yuta wins. New ROH Pure Champion Wheeler Yuta, now part of the Blackpool Combat Club, along with CM Punk, Bryan Danielson, being led by William Regal in AEW. But back to Super Card of Honor. The main event, the Ring of Honor World Championship on the line. We have Jonathan Gresham defeating, or he was the kind of, I don't know if you would say interim world champion, but since Bandido couldn't make final battle back in December, we had a match to determine a new Ring of Honor champion. Gresham won, but Bandido actually never lost the title, so two Ring of Honor world champions going at it to decide the undisputed champion here. And it is Jonathan Gresham winning this one. New Ring of Honor world champion, undisputed, I guess you could say. And then Gresham is attacked by Jay Lethal, an AEW agent, producer, coach, whatever it's called, Sanjay Dutt. And then we see the return of a Ring of Honor legend, and now Ring of Honor Hall of Famer, Samoa Joe, making his return to the promotion. And since then, we haven't really had any more updates, any more new announcements with Ring of Honor. What Tony Khan is doing, the last Ring of Honor episode has aired on Sinclair, I understand. But as of right now, I guess it's still kind of up in the air what's going to happen with Ring of Honor. The title, Gresham's still defending the world title, and Mercedes Martinez is the interim Ring of Honor women's champion. Deonna Purrazzo is still the actual Ring of Honor women's champion. She wasn't at Supercard of Honor because she was at the Impact Wrestling multiverse matches show. So I'm sure somewhere down the line, somewhere either Impact or AEW Ring of Honor, I don't know, whatever show, they're going to have a match for to determine an undisputed champion between those two, which will be a great match, I'm sure. And some news real quick before I get into another show I'm going to talk about, and that is the announcement last week on last Wednesday night's Dynamite. Tony Khan made an announcement along with the president of New Japan Pro Wrestling. It was one of the ones being rumored about this most recent big announcement, which was the joint pay-per-view super show going to be taking place June 26th. All Elite Wrestling, New Japan Pro Wrestling joining forces for a pay-per-view called The Forbidden Door, June 26th. Will definitely be interesting to see who will be on the show, what New Japan talent will be on the show, what matches we will see, because there are definitely a lot of dream matches with wrestlers on both rosters you definitely would love to see in the ring together for a match. June 26th. Forbidden Door, I'm sure we will get, still have a while till then, so I'm sure in the months coming up, we will get announcements, match announcements, talent announcements. I'm guessing this is going to be like a regular pay-per-view, probably pay-per-view, Bleacher Report, and Fight TV outside of the United States, internationally, as usual. And just another quick update. I mentioned it on the last podcast I done about almost a month ago, maybe a little less, but AEW Dynamite coming to Detroit. I said then at the time that I would like to go get tickets, and the good news is got the tickets, got them right here. So going June 29th, my first live AEW show, Dynamite. Of course, the Rampage taping, Dark Elevation, Little Caesars Arena. The first time AEW will be in Michigan. And looking forward to that, of course. And now, gonna talk about another show, a pay-per-view from this Saturday night, Impact Wrestling Rebellion, live from Poughkeepsie, New York. And we start off with the Countdown to Rebellion, which you could have watched either on, I believe this is the first time they've done the pre-show live on Impact Plus. I think that's a good idea. I don't remember them doing the Countdown show on Impact Plus before, unless I just don't remember it, but I believe this was the first time. And also did on Impact Wrestling's YouTube channel, and the Countdown show, we were gonna have a Ring of Honor World Championship match, Eddie Edwards challenging Jonathan Gresham, but he was not cleared from the concussion from the match at AEW Battle of the Belts. So there was a replacement for Jonathan Gresham, Chris Bay, and that match got moved up to the Countdown show. But very good match here, and I think they should still kept it on the main pay-per-view card, but hey, you got something for free, so that's good, I guess. And then the Influence defeat the Inspiration, and then we start the main card, Impact Wrestling Rebellion. The commentators, Tom Hannafan, got his name right that time, finally, and the Drama King, Matt Raywalt. These two are very good together, and it's been a little bit now, and these two are very good. At first, when they did the angle of Honor No More taking out D'Lo Brown, and because I like them together, Hannafan and D'Lo Brown, I thought were good. And I was thinking, oh, great. That's I like D'Lo. And then, but Raywalt has been very good on commentary. I know he's doing New Japan Strong 2 with Ian Riccaboni. And these two are great together, in my opinion. And we start off the pay-per-view with a three-way match. Steve Maclin defeating Chris Sabin and Jay White, 12 minutes, 19 seconds. The AAA Reina de Reina's championship is on the line now. Deanna Purrazzo defending against making her return to Impact Wrestling WrestleMania weekend at the Matches of the Multiverse, Taya Valkyrie. And we see a new champion here as Valkyrie defeats Deonna Purrazzo 9 minutes 3 seconds. And I like Taya, nothing against her at all. But part of me is sad to see this title reign of Deonna Purrazzo in, since she was the champ at one time, the Impact Wrestling Knockouts champion. She had the Ring of Honor, or still has the Ring of Honor Women's Championship, and then the AAA Reina de Reinas Championship, which she has now lost to Taya Valkyrie, but she really impressed me this reign. Great heel. I think she's kind of underrated, actually, because unfortunately, Impact is not really getting the attention of the wrestling world right now. Of course, for just people that are just casual fans, they just think WWE, and then like more kind of the hardcore smart internet fans watch AEW. You got AEW New Japan, you got MLW, NWA, so much wrestling right now. Impact kind of unfortunately doesn't get noticed as much as it should. And yes, I'm kind of like still the TNA, people still think of some of the bad stuff that happened during the TNA years, but Impact Wrestling has been great for the last few years. Like I said, just doesn't get really the attention as it should and the credit as it should. But let's get back to the pay-per-view. And backstage we have GM Miller with the Impact Wrestling Knockouts champion Tasha Steelz, who I also been impressed with. And now the Impact X Division Championship is now on the line. And we have Trey Miguel defending against Ace Austin and Speedball Mike Bailey in a triple threat match, three-way match, and great match here. I definitely recommend this one if you missed it. Ace Austin once again becoming the X Division champion, pinning Trey Miguel. 10 minutes, 23 seconds, new Impact Wrestling world champion. And we have Jonah taking out Tomohiro Ishii. Hard hitting match. These two were, I thought, pretty good together. And it is Ishii getting the win. 14 minutes, 49 seconds. Impact Wrestling World Tag Team Championships are on the line. We have Matt Cardona and Brian Myers starting off against Jordan Grace and W. Morrissey. This was a team that was not announced ahead of the pay-per-view. And I have to admit, this pairing surprised me. I was not expecting that, but Cardona and Myers advance, but then Morrissey and Grace get in the ring and beating them up a little bit. The Good Brothers are out representing the Bullet Club, and they advance, and then they take on Johnny Swinger and Zicky Dice. The Good Brothers again advance, and then next up is Rich Swann and Willie Mack, and again they advance. Honor No More is out next. Matt Taven and Mike Bennett. And this time, Honor No More advances. And then Rhino and Heath come in and knock out Honor No More. They advance. And then Violent by Design, the defending Impact Ring, the Impact Tag Team Champions. And they win this one, defeating Rhino and Heath. Still Impact Wrestling World Tag Team Champions. Violent by Design, the Impact Knockouts Championship is up next in this next match. Tasha Steelz versus Rosemary. Pretty good match here. Is Tasha Steelz retaining? And the main event of the evening for the Impact Wrestling World Championship, Moose taking on Josh Alexander. This one had a great story. leading into the pay-per-view back to October at Bound for Glory, Josh Alexander defeating Christian Cage to become the Impact World Champion. Moose, who won the Call Your Shot gauntlet earlier on in the night, coming out when Alexander was celebrating with his wife and his son, the ultimate heel move, cashing in and defeating Alexander, who just become the champion, immediately taking it away from him. And then Moose recently going after Alexander's family again, and we see Alexander's youngest son out with him. Very good match here, and it is Josh Alexander getting the win to become the new Impact Wrestling World Champion. And we have the feel-good moment at the end, Josh Alexander celebrating his title victory with his wife and his son. And fortunately, this time it does not get interrupted by anybody, not spoiled. So Josh Alexander, new Impact Wrestling World Champion, great match and a very good card. I thought this pay-per-view, I definitely recommend checking out the replay on either your pay-per-view provider or Fight TV. And if you missed it, definitely recommend the main event. Other matches on the show were good as well. I would say a very good show. I wouldn't say great, but still very good thumbs up. Maybe not a great show. And so I definitely recommend checking the replay out if you missed it. And that's it for this episode of 360 Wrestling Fanatic, episode 284. Thank you for listening on Spreaker, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Anchor, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, all that good stuff. And watching on YouTube. Hope to be back with another episode soon. I don't know when I'll stream again, but I probably won't do that for every episode, but occasionally I might do a stream along with the audio podcast. But hope to be back soon with another episode of 360 Wrestling Fanatic. Thank you for tuning in. If you have an email, if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, anything, 360 Wrestling Podcast at gmail.com. Have it in the description, of course. And on Anchor, you can go there if you want to support 360 Wrestling Podcast. It doesn't have to be much at all, if you can, but it'll definitely help 360 Wrestling Podcast out, make 360 Wrestling Podcast better. And for some reason, the stream went blank. Luckily, it's at the end. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but I don't know what happened, but and for some reason, the camera went blank. I don't know why. But like I said, it's the end anyway. So hopefully it will be better next time. Until then, I am Lance. And I am a wrestling fanatic.